After as many as 57 minor girls tested positive for COVID-19 in a shelter home in Kanpur, a plea has been filed in the Supreme Court seeking better facilities for the inmates of the childcare institutions. Advocate Aparna Bhat, in her capacity as an amicus curiae, has filed an application before the Supreme Court seeking better facilities and implementations of the court's guidelines as regard preventions of the spread of the COVID-19 in childcare institutions in her plea. Bhat has highlighted that the reports concerning 57 minor girls in shelter homes in Kanpur testing positive for the contagion, out of this 57, 5 are pregnant, while the one is also an HIV positive, the plea points out. An application seeking for directions to provide appropriate medical treatment and facilities to the girl who had been tested positive for COVID-19 in a shelter homes in Kanpur, Uttar Pradesh, have been filed before the Supreme Court in the matter regarding exploitations of children in orphanages in the state of Tamil Nadu, filed by amicus curiae Aparna Bhat. The application comes at the heels of the press release issued by the National Human Rights Commission with regards to their suo motu cognizance of the media reports that 57 minor girls tested positive for COVID-19 at the state-run children's shelter home in Kanpur, Uttar Pradesh. Furthermore, 5 of the girls were also found to be pregnant and 1 girl was HIV positive. The application seeks a report on their health conditions on a regular basis, as well as directions to the center to issue an advisory to all child welfare committees to ensure that children who are being newly admitted into any CCIS are suitably quarantined before allowing them to be placed in CCIS, and the necessary resources for the same be allocated by the Union of India as an interim measures to meet the extraordinary requirements of the pandemic. In addition to the above, the application also prays for directs to the centers to immediately identify homes for the purposes of quarantining children who are COVID-19 positive and or who are in need of being quarantined, since their immediate history cannot be assessed and they may be asymptomatic carriers. Directions for making testing mandatory before testing new children in the CCIS has also been prayed for. The respondent have also been directed to substantiate the mechanisms put in place to ensure the compliance of the order dated 5 December 2018 passed by the Supreme Court in the instant petition, including the activation of a centralized database of children living in CCIS. The 2018 order have been passed in a writ petition wherein the Union of India had been directed to undertake the preparations of a report on the basis of data collected with respect to the management of institutions and the rights of children. The reports was to serve as a plan or a vision document for the immediate future. However, the application contends that the order is yet to be complied with. Even though more than 18 months have passed, the application has been filed to emphasize on the urgent needs for medical treatment and facilities to be provided to the girls in Kanpur, while suggesting other directions that must be taken by the institutions. Bureau report.